By the anointing of the Holy Spirit, they shall be signed with a special character and be configured to Christ at least, so that they will receive the mission to act in the person of Christ Jesus. Called to serve the people of God, they will be part of one priesthood in union with the bishop, while being in charge of the different priests. Our ordaining prelate is His Excellency, Most Reverend Jose Araneta Habanatan, Doctor of Divinity, Bishop of Malay Malay. He will be assisted by Father Jose Villegas Ayon, Provincial Superior of the Augustinians of the Assumption, and Father Bernard Walser, Local Superior of the Augustinians of the Assumption. Reverend Peter Antonis Jr. of the Order of St. Augustine will serve as deacon. Please rise and let us join in the singing of the entrance.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, with hearts full of gratitude and jubilation, we gather today around the table of the Lord's Word and Sacrament as His chosen people, called to holiness, sharing the one priesthood of Christ, and participating in Christ's mission as priest, prophet, and king. We witness the immensity of God's love, relying on the abundance of His love and grace. We ordain our brother priest to the order of the diaconate, and our brother Taylor to the order of the priesthood. Through the laying of on hands and the invocation of the Holy Spirit, you will be consecrated as God's servants and minister to His church, leading His people through service, proclaiming His word through His words and deeds, and celebrating the mysteries of His love. As we join Jesus' offering to Himself to the Father, let us pray for our dear brothers, priests, and Jacob, and for all the ordained ministers of the church, with us entrusting the memory of our Mother. May they be obedient and faithful to God every moment of their lives. May they live pure and holy lives and may realize the daily sacrament of God's love in the world. And so, dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Thank you.
give increase to the peoples who believe in you. Look with favor on those who have chosen, and glow in the blessed immortality, those who born through the sacrament of baptism. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated as you listen to the word of God.
The first reading, a reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Observing the boldness of Peter and John, and perceiving them to be uneducated or the leaders, elders, and scribes were amazed, and they recognized them as the companions of Jesus. Then when they saw the man who had been cured standing there with them, they could say nothing in reply, so they ordered them to leave the Sanhedrin and conferred with one another, saying, "What are we to do with these men? Everyone living in Jerusalem knows that a remarkable sign was done through them, but we cannot deny it. But so that it may not be spread any further among the people, let us give them this word of warning, never again to speak anyone this name." So we called them back and ordered them not to speak or teach at all in the name of Jesus. Peter and John, however, said to them in reply, "Whether it is right in the sight of God for us to obey you rather than God, you be the judges. It is impossible for us not to speak about what we have seen and heard." After threatening them further, they released them, finding no way to punish them on account of the people who were all praising God for what they had. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will give thanks to you for When Jesus had risen early on the first day of the week, he appeared first to Mary Magdalene, out of whom he had driven seven demons. She went on to tell his companions who were mourning and weeping. When they heard that he was alive, he had been seen by her, did not believe. After this, he appeared in another form to two of them, walking along on their way to the country. They returned and told the others that they did not believe them either. But later, as the 11 were at table, he appeared to them and rebuked them for their unbelief and hardness of heart, because they had not believed those who saw him after he had been raised. He said to them, "Go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel to every creature." The Gospel of the Lord.
Ordination of Reverend James Both of them are all from our place. Reverend James from Kamehameha and our Father James, in a little while, Father James, and then Reverend Priest is from our diocese of Laipana, Debono. We are near to each other, Kamehameha and Bukidnon. And people are old and mystified. Why? That these two young professionals heed the call of the Lord to the priesthood, especially in our times today. Why they exchange their good career in favor of serving the church as priests? In our pastoral systematic, this Easter season, and living during the passion and death of Christ, soldiers, for instance, during the resurrection of our Lord, exchange the news, the good news of the resurrection for a son or not. Our Lord was put to death in exchange of a son of God. But these two young men will now receive the grace of ordination. They have renounced the criminal positions in exchange with the Lord, for the sake of serving Him, and for the sake of serving the church. In times today, priests are called free to proclaim the goodness of the resurrection, the goodness of the gospel of life, of the gospel of God. In our first reading, the apostles were told not to proclaim the name of Jesus. They were baffled what to do with the apostles. And then the apostles were brave enough. Let us obey God rather than man. Let us not stop proclaiming Jesus in our age. You see the prophetic call of the priest, all of us, especially the priest. And here you can see already the challenge of honor of Mary, our mother and inspiration. We can learn from her the life of servanthood which our brothers here today want to embrace in their lives as Augustinians of the functions we have seen. Mary's yes is a proof of her love and faith to God. Her yes is the fulfillment of the promise. It is said that the cosmos was created not that there will be manifold things in heaven and earth, but that there might be space for the covenant between God and man. A space for the covenant between God and man. We know very well that it was fulfilled by our Lord Jesus Christ, but Mary is instrumental to this fulfillment of the promise. Here yes is the fulfillment of the promise. Here yes makes this possible. Here yes changes the course of history from the perspective of our faith and makes the mystery of salvation possible. Mary abandons her personal plan and embraces the will of God with her whole life and with her whole heart. Hence, we give thanks to Mary, the mother of all priests, for all their love and fidelity to God's call. The Blessed Virgin Mary's yes also. Blessed Mary clarifies her identity as a humble and servant of the Lord. When we reply to the angel, he said, "I am the maid servant of the Lord. Be it done unto me according to thy word." Here she taught us how to be a servant before the Lord. A servant is one who openly offers or commits himself or herself to the Lord. And this is the life that our brothers here want to embrace in their lives. This total offering was also manifested by the Lord Himself, by Jesus Himself. It is incarnation, it is life and ministry, and in his paschal mystery, in his passion, death, and resurrection. This is something that we shall continue to ponder, especially in this Easter season. My dear friends, in a little while, we will witness our brothers here affirming their yes to God, to loving God, who calls them to a ministry of love and humble service. Like the Blessed Virgin Mary, they too will make public their lifetime commitment to God and to the Church. Reverend Jay, or Father Jay, I knew was an employee of Philhel. During one of our Presbyterian meetings in the beginning of autumn, a group of them, together with him as the head, talked about us during our meeting, about the benefits, the duties, and responsibilities of being a Philhel member. It is good that just for us, please, but also for our poor parishioners, especially our Catholics. That's my first encounter with him. And he has classmates also at Xavier University who became priests. So he was instrumental in, you know, providing Philhel to our priests, especially with the Catholic, and also to our poor parishioners, our Catholics, lay workers. Reverend Chris also, who hails from the diocese of Malaybalay in Dibun, is an agriculture graduate at Xavier University. He worked at one of the agricultural companies in Bukidnon. Most of the people in Bukidnon are farmers, and they are used to serve the earth and people as well. So it is all about integral ecology. Father Jay, before, was concerned about the health of people. It's a matter of health, but now, I think God called him to be concerned not just for the health of physical health, but critical health, body, mind, and spirit. It is now a matter of faith. We live in peace. It's also about particular ecology, according to Pope Francis in the Laudato. Our concern for the human person, our concern for the earth. It's now called not to sow seeds of some plants and fruits, but to sow the seeds of the gospel, like in the parable of the sower, and to nurture it among the people from all walks of life. The two of you are called to be holy, healthy, and happy priests, proclaiming the joy of the gospel. And we are here to witness to that calling as a response to God today. But perhaps you may ask, what does women's servanthood mean in our contemporary times? What does servanthood really mean? Does servanthood mean only about the function that we're talking about? In the Gospels and in the teachings of the Church, we talk about servant leadership or servanthood. It is primarily not about functions, but the roles to be done. In the Scriptures, it defines, or it does not define, but describe a deacon, the person of a deacon, a presbyter, or an episcopus. So it is not telling us about the function of a deacon, a function of a priest, or a function of a presbyter, a function of the episcopus, but more of the person of a deacon, a priest, and a bishop. In his letter, St. Paul to Timothy, he said, and it describes a deacon, a presbyter, as a person who must be a respectable man, whose word can be trusted, moderate in the amount of wine, and with no solid plea for value. Samo ko yung naman pa, pinahanan, ang mga katapang ngayon sa Iglesia, dilit magbalabit inom, o dilit ako, kinahanglan na magkapadayon sila sa pagkukot sa kapadayat at kamanuunan sa pagtuo, inumanan sa putli na konsensya. We see here the description of St. Paul of deacon or presbyter or episcopos or bishop. So servanthood here does not really mean function of a servant, but first of all, the person of the servant. It is a way of life where one finds a resource from Jesus himself, the model servant of the Lord. It is really by God's grace, a divine initiative, that these young brothers of ours are chosen to minister like the Blessed Virgin Mary. Although unlike the Blessed Virgin Mary, we and Father Jade who will increase are really not worthy of that calling. But it is God's magnanimous love that makes us worthy. We do not merit the call. That is why as you publicly affirm God's call today, you are also called to live your life in the ministry with full of love and humility. So pinasayang pa ang lihok sa Ginoo, ganun na the bawos. Humility, humble service. Kailangan siya Diyos, Diyokas nini, unang pagkatao, unang musuntanon sa mahal, hangkot sa kamatayan. Usap, ingon sa tini ng kinabuhin sa tumahal ng Birhen, sa iyang pagpuyon sa kagutman sa Ginoo. So here we see the descending movement of the Lord, filled with love, moved by love, and inspired by love. In our ordination, sa ating ordination sa pagkadiakono, pagkabali, o pagkabispo, managdasal na sa usap na hierarchical ladder. As if we are climbing a hierarchical ladder, the deacon here, presbyter, the bishop, marunay ang-ang, marunay over na itong kaputon sa kinabuhi. It is as if we are really climbing a hierarchical ladder. But in the eyes of faith, we are descending so that we will be filled with God's love and strength and be able to proclaim God's word among our people. So we are not ascending, but we should be descending as deacon, as presbyter, and as a bishop. Even the Pope is called the servus. The servant of the servant of the Lord. Sa ato pa, wala siya the sangka, kundi rin God, paobos. So that we can be filled with God's love, strength, to continue the mission that He has entrusted us to us. Sa ato pa, mawagilig sa iyon, giving response to nila, mag-isamon ka natin sa Ginoo. Isip mag-alaman sa simbahan as different priests with presbyter or bishops. We need to continually grow in holiness by being in contact always with a good shepherd so that being with him, or if we say Augustine, by being with him, by becoming like him, we become the heart of the good shepherd. So that is our prayer for Father Jay. Please, never stop being in touch with the Lord, being in contact with our God. The grace of the Good Shepherd, the grace of the charism of the Good Shepherd that has entrusted to you will always be there as we also approach it always with our prayers. Because only in that manner that we can continually live our life as God's servants. May you be inspired also by your founder, Father Emmanuel. And this time, I would not like to say the last family name because I might mispronounce his family name, Father Emmanuel. Be inspired by his holy life. He truly exemplifies what we are saying about servanthood in God's love. He was able to love and serve the poor during his time. But allow himself to be the channel of God's care and God's love for all people. We hope that in your life and in your ministry, you can also see Mother Mary being alive in your life and in your midst, in our midst. And above all, that with your life and in your ministry, we can see Christ in the way you love and serve others, especially those who are poor and needy. Congratulations to both of you.
Please remain seated. We will now have the examination of the candidates to the diaconate and the priesthood respectively. Then the candidates will promise obedience, by virtue of which they make themselves available to the service of the Church and to undertake the many important tasks, obligations, and responsibilities proper to their office.
With him to consecrate yourself to God for the salvation of all. they do it with the help of God.
Do you promise respect and obedience to your holy money and their religious behavior?
I do.
May God, who has begun a good work in you, bring it to fulfillment.
Please rise.
But dear people, let us pray that the all-powerful Father will mercifully pour out the riches of His blessing on these His servants, whom in His kindness reaches to the holy orders of the happening and the priesthood.
Oh. Forever and ever.
Gospels.
through the end of our Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, Author of human divinity. It is you, a portion of all graces. Through you, everything progresses. Through you, all things are made to stand firm. To form a priestly people, to appoint ministers to your Christ, your Son, with the power of the Holy Spirit, arranging them in different orders. Already in the earlier covenant, offices arose, established through mystical rites. When you sent Moses and Aaron over your people to confirm and sanctify them, you chose men next to ground and dignity to accompany them and assist them in their task. So through the desert, you implanted the spirit of Moses in the hearts of 70 wise men. And with the help, he ruled over your people to great peace. So also upon the sons of Aaron, he poured an abundant share of their father's plenty. But the number of the priests prescribed by the law might be sufficient for the sacrifices of the tabernacle, which were the shadow of the good things to come. But in these last days, Holy Father, you sent your Son into the world, Jesus, who is apostle and high priest of our confession. Through the Holy Spirit, he offered himself to you as a spotless victim, and he made his apostles consecrated in the truth, sharers in his mission. You provided them also with companions to proclaim and carry out the work of salvation throughout the whole world. And now we beseech you, Lord, in our weakness, to grant us this helper that we need to exercise the priesthood that comes from the apostles. Grant, we pray, Almighty Father, to these your servant and dignity of the priesthood. If you get within him the spirit of holiness, may henceforth possess this office which comes from you, O God, and is destined to grant to the office of bishop, and when the example of his manner of life be instilled right hand. May he be a worthy co-worker with our order, so that by his preaching and through the grace of the Holy Spirit, the words of the gospel may bear fruit in human hearts and reach even to the ends of the earth. Together with us, may he be a faithful steward of your mysteries, so that your people may be renewed in the waters of the earth and nourished on your altar, so that sinners may be reconciled and the sleep raised up. May you be joined with us, Lord, in imploring your mercy for the people entrusted to his care and for all the world. And so may the full number of the nations gathered together in Christ be transformed to your one people and made perfect in your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Thank you.
same provision of the Holy Spirit to be offered to God, understand what to do, imitate what to celebrate, and conform your life to the mystery of the Lord's cross.
The place of peace is an expression of the intimate union of deacons and priests with the bishop and their collegiality with those who are ordained to ministry.
that we always find delight in these crystal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly occurs within us, may be the cause of our unending joy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And raise them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to proclaim you, O Lord, but on this day to love you more gloriously, with Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb, who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every man, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic host sing together the ending hymn of your glory as the end.
Thank you.
blessing and coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the mission of your church and recognizing the sacrificial giving, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us a covered offering to you, so that we may open and connect us with your life, especially in the most persecuted Mary, Mother of God, with a just against us, with your wisdom, most particularness, with St. Augustine. Marie Vigenie of Jesus. And with the blessed wounded garment, coming back to this world, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession of their presence, we regard you with taking care of you.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth. With your servant Francis, our Pope, Ernesto, our Bishop, and Jose, our ordaining pillar, the all our bishops, is your servant who have been ordained today as deacon and priest for the Church, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of your family, whom you have sought before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered to all the world.
Remember your servants, Cecilio, Lorna, Maradisa, Maria Santario, and Joaquin Jr., whom you have called from this world to yourself. Glad that they, who are united with your Son on death at peace, will also be one with him in his resurrection. Then from the earth, he will raise up in the flesh those who have died. Transform our lowly body after the pattern of his corporeal soul. Our departed mothers and sisters, into all who are pleasing to you, and passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope you enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. You will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you our God as you are, we shall delight you for all the ages and praise you in our day. Through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow in the world, all of us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Oh,
await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
Oh, Lord, my God, By the Christ.
let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those who were pleased to renew their eternal destinies, be attained in their fest, the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Now, we listen to some words of acknowledgement from Reverend Chris, and thereafter, from Father Jim.
Thanks be to God, hallelujah, hallelujah. That's our acclamation as people of God, praising and thanking God in His victory against death and sin. Thanks be to God, hallelujah, hallelujah. This is also the acclamation of my heart today, for the blessing, for the great blessing that God has showered upon me. God has given this blessing from Him, but through many channels of blessings also, to you all who are here, who journey with me and Jay. This makes the blessing so special and so enormous. With this, let us thank you from all our hearts for journeying with us, and hopefully still journeying with us as we endeavor, as we try to be faithful as a servant of God. First, I will thank my Christian Assumption congregation. I will thank Father Miguel Diaz, Miguel Diaz, I know him, our superior, our provincial superior. Thank you, dear. I will thank Father Bernard Musler, our territory superior. I thank also Father Suando, who prepared us. He is our retreat master as we prepare for this ordination, whose trespasses can be also I. All our brothers, friends, I would like to thank my familiar and our novice master, Father Guaya Chirimbaye. Thank you very much, Father, for guiding me. I also thank Father Mirjan, Father Andre, Father Ding, Father Ed. Thank you very much, Father. I thank my previous brothers, Brother Eddie, Brother Red, Brother Leo, Brother Elmer, Father Joseph Yen. Thank you very much, Father, for joining with me. By our novices that serve as our altar servers, Brother Melody, Mark James, Jimmy, John, Dagober. Thank you very much, brothers, and they are also my in the same community. Thank you very much, brothers, for your paternal love. I thank also the postulants that serve in the choir today, and also some is in the serving, and also po yung po sa community. So marami siyang comments na mga sa akin. So, thanks for Father Ben, Joseph Paul, thank you very much, brothers. To the contacts who are here, thank you very much, brothers. And also a very special brother is with me in the leadership and is representing the associations in Korea. Thank you very much, brother, Mr. Virgil. Thank you, brother. I would like to thank also the Assumption family, the Oblate Sisters of the Assumption, our one and only, Sister Bora. Thank you very much, Sister. All rise to the Assumption, in their spirit is praying with us today, and also the religious of the Assumption Sisters. Sisters, thank you very much. I would like also to thank the Assumption family, the Assumption Sisters, for their support in our mission, for their support, for their prayer. Also sisters, thank you very much. The Osa brothers, Osa Intramuros, Osa Cebu, thank you very much. I would like to thank also the Escopa Pintor, whom I serve in my apostolate, serving them in Escopa. Thank you for your coming here, and thank you for your name with me. Also, I would like to thank the Association of Religious Treasurers, especially the good group, and I think the chairperson is here, Sister Teresa Aspin of RBN. Thank you very much, Sister. Thank you very much. also the other core group, thank you for your support also and your presence. Then I'd like to thank some of the Kalaobos members are here from Biat Cagayan. They are the group of our neighbor, our benefactors, who continue to support our scholarship program. So they are here to journey with me and to thank you all for the things, for the help that you extend to them. So two of them are here this time. This time to be with you guys. They are big and also friends, relatives, and family. My mother is here, Nay Salama. My brother and sister is here, Mr. Indo and Yanis. Thank you very much for the help. I'd like also to say special thanks to Father George De Chavez for his play. This year, I would like to thank him for giving me the opportunity. Maybe it will be announced later. But thank you very much, Father, in advance for this opportunity for me. Thank you. Personally, thank and I give this opportunity to thank you all, and I will call most reverend Father Director Epanias A.
Thank you so much.
27, Cecilio Lili Iguanias. That is why my uncle, my father, brother, my mom, is here standing for him. He was, or he is our father after the death of our biological father, the former mayor of the Capitol in exile. Thank you. Of course, my beautiful sisters are here, my elders are here. Sisters, Ana Marisa, then our youngest sister, Mary Lucero. They are with their kids and their husbands. My clan is here also. Pagkabihan di Oro, Bohol, Cebu, Malinua, whatever. To my family, thank you so much for your generosity. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for sharing me with the whole church. You know, I was trying to remind myself, what is with April 22? What's so significant with April 22? And then I remembered when I lived through my journey. In 2008, April 22, during our family meeting, I made the announcement that I will become a religious. And that's why, today. And they were so silent, but I was told that they cried a lot. They flooded the air with their tears. Of course, I'd like to thank the OLPP family, because that's a lady of Pentecost Parish, because they received me and welcomed me to serve here as a deacon for more than 1 year. Mother Dennis, the parish priest, thank you so much. And to all the members of the Parish Pastoral Council, they're here, the MBG, the greeters, the commissioners, and our neighbors here in Varsity Hills, thank you very much. To the people of Benitao, I saw my youth there. Thank you so much, because that is where I made my apostolate together with apostolates every Sunday. And tomorrow, during my first Mass, I will celebrate it with them. So please be there, especially the youth. And get impatient with you. But I'm really impressed. Thank you so much for listening and welcoming us to your rooms. Dakwa, thank you so much. I forgot you last year. Thank you for singing, especially the favorite songs in Siguano. Marami paghanding kayo sa lahat sa inyo. To my fellow formators of Sojourn, and the postulants of St. George, thank you so much. Then my father Eric of the Passionist is here. To my colleagues in PhilHealth, Bishop Joe mentioned this already, some of them are here. To my classmates in grade school, high school, college, and to my best friend, he is a lawyer and now a elected counselor of Ormoc City, the future mayor of Ormoc City, Attorney Lawrence Nina. To my classmates at LSD, some of them are prisoners and some of them not there. But thank you so much for that. To my former professors, my teachers in high school, Father Joe is here, the spiritual director before. My teachers at LSP, they are here. My former students, they are also here. Your teacher is Dr. To our friends, our Lay Assumption Alliance members, our benefactors, finally, please join me and Brother Chris, Reverend Chris, sorry, in thanking our Mother Mary, Our Lady of Pentecost, Our Lady of Winsor.
Peace, friends.
Amen. May He, the whose believing word, you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, Thank you, leaders, for the eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And may you have already accepted Christ in baptism through faith, believing in a right manner on this earth, being united with Him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, alleluia, alleluia.
Duly ordained priest Father Jay will impart his first presenting blessing to His Excellency, Most Reverend Joseph Antan, Doctor of Divinity. After which, Father Jay will impart us his blessing. Please remain standing.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.